Stadium in Hamilton, New York. Colgate to kick it away to start the third quarter.
They certainly come out with the momentum, having scored 13 unanswered. Kutschke's kick into the wind,
and Brendan Moore with a little bit of room on the outside.
Very good speed. He is a linebacker. Some extracurriculars on that run back, but good field position for Lehigh at the 40-yard line. Now the first half stats. And Colgate certainly got the better of it in terms of rushing. Lehigh had difficulty moving the ball on the ground.
Well, I think clearly Lehigh at halftime had to spend a lot of time on their offensive execution. They have not figured out this Red Raider defense. And it's pretty amazing that Colgate's overcome four turnovers.
Stand block, give to Brett Snyder, who has certainly shouldered a much bigger workload on the ground than in previous games. Well, Phil Stambaugh needs but 4 yards to overtake Marty Horn, who graduated in 1985 as the all-time leading passer in one of the great passing schools in the country. Pass complete to
Cody Fedorcha. Right there. That's probably the all-time record on that completion right there.
That should do it. And when you think of the level of aerial artistry, Kim, and congratulations to Phil Stambaugh, because that is noteworthy when you are the all-time leader at a school like Lehigh, which passes so well. When you consider the level of aerial artistry going back to the early 70s, when you sort of ushered in this era, it is really remarkable how well they have executed the pass offense over the last quarter century. Third down, one, and first down.
Aerial artistry, I like that.
Well, I like that. I mean, you take a look at the string of quarterbacks. McQuilkin, Oliva, there is Marty Horn.
Looks like he's got a little grin on his face.
Marty Horn does the color for the radio broadcast alongside Matt Kerr. First down, 10. Moore in motion. Stambaugh rolling to his right. Nobody's open. He's got a little bit of room to run. Stambaugh, second pretty good run of the day, but he pays a little bit of a price. There is a flag down on the play.
Yeah, I think Phil Stambaugh also showing, hey, he's a tough guy too. We saw Ryan Venez sort of act on the sidelines in terms of being animated about his leadership ability. Phil Stambaugh coming out here and saying, hey, I'm in this football game too, but unfortunately on his scramble, Lehigh is guilty of yet another penalty. And these penalties are going to be increasingly harder to overcome as the Red Raider offense continues to click.
Clipping on the offense, 15 yards. Replay.
Hey, a 15-yard penalty on first down is really tough. Right now, if you're Lehigh, you've got first and 25. You've got to think in terms of getting just small pieces of it back on first and second down.
Josh Snyder in motion, first down, 25. Stambaugh throws, they get a small piece of it back, as Kim mentioned.
Stambaugh took a lick that time, too.
Brian Schaefer made the stop for Colgate.
They're going to go no huddle here, Rich.
Second down, 15. Gain of 10 on the play. Ball is at the Lehigh 42-yard line, just underway second half. Colgate with the momentum. The mojo, as Kim said. Pass is complete to Ricky Moore. And Ricky Moore should have the first down.
No, he's short. Still got 10 yards to go.
I'm
but
sorry.
That play is so effective when Stambaugh gets rid of the ball early. Watch this right here. Moore's going to have time to turn it upfield, and that's what you want to look at. He's got the ball early, so he's got time to turn it upfield. That gains you another 5 yards. Look at Stambaugh. This is a semi-roll out here to his right. Hits the ball on the run. Boy, he put that ball right on the money.
Third down, 9. Quick release. Stambaugh complete, and now they have the first down. Ricky Moore down to the 35-yard line. And Stambaugh there shows you the arm strength.
quick release.
Well, not only that, it's a real good job of reading the secondary, because Tom McCarroll, the strong safety, 38, he was sitting there right in that zone, and the receiver just checked down inside, and Stambaugh knew he was checking down inside, and he got him the ball.
First down out of the shotgun. Stambaugh fires, and it's complete to Peltzer. McCarroll makes the tackle for Colgate. Ball is down to the 31-yard line. Second down, 7 with 12:22. 7 straight completions now for Stambaugh, who is starting to get on track. Ronald Jean outside, and there goes Ronald Jean. Jean down to the 13-yard line. 17-yard run for the powerhouse speedster.
Lehigh offense finally gelling. Look at 77. That's Steve Ludwig. He's got his hands extended. He's trying to keep him within the plane. But the key was staying on the defender, and that allowed Ronald Jean to slip behind. Look at Jean slipping behind Steve Ludwig downfield. Big number 77 way downfield, making a nice block.
Jean abandoned as a 13-year-old by his mother, abused, shuttled through a number of shelters and foster homes. What a story, has found success here at Lehigh. Stambaugh. Josh Snyder. Snyder inside the bar. Touchdown, Lehigh! And that was the Lehigh offense on that drive that we have seen all year long. Snyder's fifth reception of the day, so the Snyder brothers have been instrumental this afternoon for Kevin Higgins' squad. Jaron Tate is on to make it 24-14 with Heibel on the hole. Kick is good, and so Lehigh answers the bell at the start of the third quarter, and they lead it 24-13.
Catch all the excitement, color, and fun with Pennsylvania's newest family attraction. At the Crayola Factory, the fun never ends. Right before your eyes, you'll see Crayola crayons and markers being made. And kids of all ages can play and experiment with dozens of exciting activities. And the Crayola store is a one-of-a-kind sensation, offering the most colorful and unique Crayola products and gifts. Both attractions are located on Center Square in Easton, just minutes from Route 22 and I-78.
We have a service agreement with Fritz right from 1972. Well, anyway, there were real problems with that furnace. And through the service agreement, they essentially fixed everything so that it was like having a new furnace. When they came that time to fix all the problems that existed with that furnace, we never paid one single penny.
Fritz, for comfort you can count on.
Lehigh football has a proud history and a winning tradition. A tradition that's built on ambitious goals, a sound game plan, and teamwork. At First Union, we use the same approach to enrich and simplify your life. We offer the widest variety of financial products and solutions. Services range from traditional checking and savings products to investments and trust planning. Call us and let us introduce you to our team, and together, we'll build a winning tradition.
When you're choosing a name for your baby, you want one you'll feel good about for a long, long time. It's the same when you're choosing an insurance agent for yourself. You'll want one who'll stand the test of time. And with your State Farm agent, you'll get an agent you can trust and life insurance from a company that has always received the highest possible ratings for financial strength. So call your State Farm agent today and work with a name that'll sound just as good when your kids are grown up as it does today. State Farm understands life.
What Lehigh did on the touchdown play, they substituted late. There you see the substitution coming in. They did that to have twins left so they'd have man-to-man. They had a linebacker out here man-to-man on a wideout, but he didn't get open. Stanbaugh improvises, come back and hits Josh Snyder for the touchdown. Nice job by Stanbaugh coming off the primary. And I'll tell you, Josh Snyder going into the end zone got a great block from Cody Fedorsha.
Snyder's fourth touchdown reception of the year.
But again, using the substitution angle, the no-huddle offense, any edge they can possibly get against this Red Raider defense.
First down, Vena pitches to Randall Joseph. Joseph scoops outside. Out of bounds at the 36-yard line. Joseph has been plagued by fumbles today.
Well, that was a big answer by the Lehigh offense coming out to start off the second half, putting together a cohesive drive. Now can the Red Raiders answer? Let's see what Ryan then has got here in the second half as we see nice numbers on Randall Joseph.
Picked up a first down on that previous rush. Gibbs to LeBoy. Flag down though.
Well, this is the counter. We've seen toss sweep. Now Vena this time fakes the toss sweep, comes right back up the middle with the counter. They love this play. And it looks like Lehigh's got another penalty.
Third defensive offsides today for Lehigh.
You wonder if Vena, the veteran quarterback, is using the cadence to his advantage.
Offside, defense, declined. First down.
First down for the Red Raiders. Play fake. Vena with time. Throws wide open, but not all that well thrown. That was Barry Hoare, the tight end, on the reception. Inside Lehigh territory, ball now at the 48-yard line.
Lehigh very lucky that time that Hoare had to leave his feet to catch that ball. He'd still be running. Lehigh did not cover that play well at all.
Second down, 6 yards to go for a Colgate first down. LeBoy again, first down and more. Inside the 40 to the 38-yard line.
Good offensive thrust by the Colgate offensive line that time. Matt Andrews, 25, the free safety, had to make the tackle.
First down 10, Vena pitch to Randall Joseph. Joseph gets a few yards off the right side. Second down 7 for the Red Raiders, 10 minutes to go here in the third quarter into the eyes of Matt Andrews. Fake again by Vena. Vena throws and it is incomplete, and Ryan Ojeda really took a shot. Salvaterra and Applin were there for Lehigh.
This is what Colgate does best. They come run on first down, they come out, play action second down. Vena out of the pocket, and nice coverage that time by Lehigh. This is good contact right at the football.
Flag is down at about the 40, and it will be against Colgate.
Holding on the offense, 10 yards, replay, second down.
Well, he doesn't like to see that, of course. His offense is going to have to operate now on
about second and 19, Rich.
You know, one thing we haven't seen out of Colgate is the quarterback draw. They usually run that play 3 to 4 times a game to take advantage of Venom. Still something we haven't seen yet.
Second down, 18.
Fumble.
There is a fumble.
Looks like Colgate.
Fifth Colgate turnover.
Nope, looks like Colgate's recovered.
Lydell King was the ball carrier. Colgate does recover.
But nevertheless,
third down, long yardage coming up.
This is right at the exchange. It seemed like the fullback sort of lurched into Venna as he was taking the handoff, and the ball popped loose. Colgate very lucky to recover that, but now they've got third and 20, Rich. They've really got to throw the ball downfield.
Venna,
there he goes.
And he is out of bounds, but well short of a first down. Out of bounds at about the 39-yard line.
But now a tough call if you're Dick Biddle. You're on Lehigh's 39-yard line, still early in the second half. You really don't want to punt from the 39, but it is fourth and 9. Too far for the field goal, of course. What do you do? This is a tough call. He's going to go for it. Fourth and 9. Fourth and 10.
From the 39-yard line, a very big play early second half for Colgate. Bennett with time throws, and it is incomplete. He was out of bounds.
Wow. That
Salvatore, number 30, is fired up, and that is the kind of passion the coaches really love in Matt Salvatore from Emmaus.
This was very close. You see Venna in the pocket on the sideline.
That's simply incomplete.
Oh, the ball pops out. You're right.
That's a great play by Salvatore.
Incomplete.
Excellent pass defense by the freshman from Emmaus. Stambaugh going deep for Pedorcha, and it is incomplete. There is a flag down. Flag down at the 15-yard line, indicating interference on Colgate.
Stambaugh had his choice on this play of Rick Moore, number 14, streaking down the post, or Pedorcha outside. They were both wide open. See, personal foul face mask against the Red Raiders. Let's take another look at this. You got Fedorcha on the outside. He had Moore down the middle. Pretty good defense, actually.
Personal foul, face mask on the defense, 15 yards.
Let's see it. Right there, you see his left hand right on the face mask. Right there. Great camera coverage.
And is Brandon Tinson, defensive back, and a good one. For Colgate, flag for the penalty.
But Stambaugh had Rick Moore down the post.
So it will be first down 10 from the Colgate 46. Boy, Ronald Jean is racked.
Tough
hard
defense. Mark Herman, the linebacker, 27 for Colgate. Really came up and stuffed this play.
Player down for Colgate. We're going to take a short break. Lehigh leading it 24-13, 9 minutes to go in the third quarter.
U.S. Airways, the Lehigh Valley's number one airline, is proud to be the official airline of Lehigh University Athletics. U.S. Airways operates more flights from Lehigh Valley International Airport than any other carrier and has served the community for over 30 years. Remember, Lehigh University Athletic fans, U.S. Airways begins with you.
Bedorcha. On the field, a quick decision can make the difference between a win and a loss. In life, a decision to use alcohol can mean only one thing. A loss. I won't let alcohol get in my way. I've seen so many student-athletes make this decision, and as a result, never reach their full potential. I made the decision to stay clean. Make the right choice. Don't choose alcohol.
With AT&T Digital OneRate, this is no ordinary phone. It's my you can reach me in Austin, then Denver, then Philly phone. My hey, let me pick up the kids today phone. My I'm working from home today phone. My hey honey, Michael made black belt phone.
The world of wireless has changed. AT&T Digital OneRate. No roaming or long distance charges across all 50 states. So now AT&T could make your wireless phone your only phone.
...24-13 Lehigh. Mark Herman, who made that fine play, taken off the field pretty much under his own power. Stamba under heavy pressure, throws it up, and it's incomplete. The door to the intended receiver, he took a lift. It'll bring up third down.
Well, Colgate, coming out of that second down, really anticipated the pass, came with everyone. Take a look at Cody Fedorchi going up for this ball. And look at, boy, did he get clocked.
Costantino, 42, really stuck it to Cody Fedorchi.
Third and long, Rich. Lehigh out of the shotgun. Let's see if the Red Raiders come after him again.
Third down 10 with Moore in motion. Stambaugh from the shotgun. Stambaugh is hit as he releases, and it is almost intercepted. Fourth down, Lehigh will punt it away.
A lot of pressure, number 18 that time, Alex Houston. Number 18, the defensive tackle, breaks free, and he is really going to hit Stambaugh. Take a look at it in the pocket. Here he comes. I tell you, when you're exposed like that with your arm out there, he's really lucky he wasn't injured.
Stambaugh came off the field very frustrated. Had to be consoled by Bubba Young. Not happy with the way the offense is executing. High snap, but Heibel does an excellent job of getting it away. Into the end zone, though. It'll be first down 10 for the Red Raiders at the 20-yard line.
Now, Heibel did a nice job keeping his composure that time with the high snap.
Well, for the latest information on all of Lehigh sports teams, tune in every Monday night at 8:30 for the Lehigh Sports Magazine. Join host Jeff Fisher and Lehigh's coaches and student-athletes as they review the past week's action and look forward to the week ahead. The Lehigh Sports Magazine every Monday night, 8:30 p.m. on WFMZ-TV. Randall Joseph. And a good stick is right. Michael Emery, along with Abdul Byron and Dan Guzovich in on the stop.
Take a look at the life of a middle linebacker, Brian Apley. He gets cut down below the waist. Got to get back up. Boom, you get another hit. You got to keep going forward, keep positive motion, and take a lot of hits when you're playing middle linebacker.
You're a tackler on this team.
And that's the other thing you got to do when you're the middle linebacker. You got to make a lot of tackles.
Second down, 6. 7:50 to go, third quarter. Colgate with a football, trailing 24-13. Venna, and good job defensively by Lehigh. Really no gain on the play.
What we have seen all day is Venna not getting loose on the option. Lehigh has done an excellent job of taking away the quarterback on the option. They've been successful in other ways, but so far, Venna hasn't broken free on the option. Now, 3rd and 6. 7 minutes left in the third quarter.
Benna throwing, and it is caught. First down, Colgate. On the reception is Tom Morin.
And really, that almost looked too easy. This is kind of vintage Benna. Short roll to his right. He sticks it on the outside shoulder. It was kind of like stealing.
Good reception by
Well
Morin.
Executed.
By Morin, who's a senior from Attleboro, Massachusetts, did a good job hauling that in. Ball at the 34 now. Randall Joseph straight away, brought down by Brendan Moore. Pickup of a few yards.
Otis Colgate using a lot of quick counts in the second half. It seems like the Lehigh defense isn't quite set at times. Nice positive yardage that time for the Red Raiders on first down, almost 5 yards. They love those second and fives, second and sixes. You can come with the option. You can come with a little sprint out. You can even pop a trap. A lot of options, second and five.
Gives straight away to the fullback, LaVoy, another Colgate first down. Power football for the Red Raiders. That offensive line features one first-team All-Patriot League selection from a year ago and two second-team choices from a year ago. Senior-dominated, very athletic.
Colgate, no huddle offense. Counter.
Handoff again to the fullback. Close to another Colgate first down. Gain of 9.
You really feel the Colgate offense has a rhythm going here. This is fake toss. 24, the fullback right up the middle. Nothing fancy, but effective.
Andrews made the tackle for Lehigh. Second down and 1 for Colgate at the Lehigh 43. First down, no, it was a play fake. Benna, now he has the first down. And Benna down to the 32-yard line. So Colgate responding.
Well, he's in the groove here. Play action pass on second and 1. He had the time, but nobody opened. Good coverage, but look at this. He's downfield, and you know, he's not going to go down. He's going to take somebody with him if he goes down. First down.
From the Lehigh 32, pitch to Randall Joseph. Joseph with some room off the right side. Randall Joseph down to the 21-yard line.
Lehigh really catching now on defense. An excellent job by Colgate's offensive line.
First down, Colgate. Joseph nearing the 100-yard mark, 15 carries, 95 yards. But should Colgate fall short today, some might look back at the fumbles, more so than the big numbers. LaVoy. Not much doing. Good job defensively by Ian Eason and Reuben Smith. Very interesting football game developing. 4 minutes, 12 seconds to go. Lehigh just a reset. Came in 8-0 on the season with a 20-game regular season unbeaten streak. Colgate came in having won 6 straight with a record of 7-1. Both teams with designs on the postseason. Lehigh led it 17-0, but Colgate reeled off 13 unanswered before Lehigh came back to start the second half with a score. And now Randall Joseph fighting his way down to the 15-yard line.
Down by Brian Appling.
Appling made the stop. Rich Lerner, Kim McQuilkin, and Jeff Fisher at Andy Kerr Stadium, named for the winningest coach in Colgate history, Andy Kerr. As a note, Fred Dunlap, former Lehigh coach, coached here at Colgate and still lives in Hamilton.
And Coach Dunlap is here at the game this afternoon, along with Mark Murphy, the new Colgate AD.
Benna, under pressure, gets rid of it, dangerously so, incomplete. Mentioned Mark Murphy. He enjoyed a great career with George Allen and the Washington Redskins as a strong safety.
Mark Murphy and I were teammates on the Redskins as we see Benna here just trying to make something happen as he goes down. Lucky a white shirt didn't find that ball, but, you know, Murph was a free agent on that great over-the-hill gang Redskin team. As we come up to a big fourth down here, Rich.
From the 15-yard line, Colgate has been faced with fourth downs on numerous occasions today. Pass is incomplete. And that groan from the Colgate sideline, certainly heartfelt, because Hoera, the tight end, was wide open. Bennett would love to have that one back.
Well, that time he didn't quite work his magic, but he kept sprinting out here. But this was throwback all the way to the tight end, Barry Hoera. And you're right, Rich, he was wide open. He delayed, he blocked down, then he got out in the flat there. And, man, that's a touchdown if Venna puts the ball in the money.
3 minutes to go, third quarter. Handoff, Ronald Jean. Just hasn't been a lot of running room for Jean.
No, that Colgate defensive line is doing a nice job. And I'll tell you, the Lehigh offense's job right here is to move the chains. It's not necessarily to score, but they've got to leave their defense in good field position. That's what Kevin Higgins needs out of this drive. They cannot be three and out and have Colgate take over at midfield.
Second down, nine after a one-yard pickup by Gene. Stambaugh under some pressure, and that probably will be grounding. No flags as of yet. Amon Russell was all over Stambaugh. There are no flags.
You know, in the pro game, it's the intent. If you throw the ball to avoid a sack, it's your intention, not if there's a receiver in the area. In the college game, if you have a receiver in the area, you can get away with it. And that's what Stambaugh did right there.
Stambaugh had to feel for a moment like he was back in high school wrestling there. Stambaugh throwing, and it's incomplete. Lehigh wants a trip. They're going to get it. They are going to get it. Ricky Moore was tripped up. And that's a break for Lehigh.
That's a big break for Lehigh. And that was a very close call. You can feel the emotion down on the field. Right here, you know.
He may have tripped on his own.
I don't know if I see a trip there. I'm not sure I saw any contact there at all. And as a matter of fact, they're going to pick up the flag.
That's a good call.
And I think it's a good call, too.
It's the right call.
Take another look at it. Right here, there's no contact. Phil Bowman, the cornerback, number seven. You know, it's nice to see the officials make the right call. They were right in picking up that flag.
Who needs replay?
Now, this is a tough punt.
Jay Heibel to kick it away for Lehigh from the 2 yard line. Gets it away. There's a flag down. It was not a very good punt. It's on Lehigh. Offside.
Well, Dick Biddle's going to decline this penalty because it was a very poor kick. There you see the indication by the official. And Colgate is going to take the ball right there on Lehigh's 35-yard line. Take a look at the pressure here. You know, some pressure in there low from up in the middle of the football field. But remember what we said the Lehigh offense's job was, to leave the defense in good field position. They did not succeed as Colgate starts from the Lehigh 35-yard line.
First down, 2 minutes, 7 seconds to go here in the third quarter. Give it to that pesky fullback, LaBoy, who has begun to work so well in this game. Ian Eason made the tackle. LaBoy now 8 carries, 50 yards. Ian Eason, a chemical engineering major, one of many great student athletes at Lehigh, Colgate as well. Lehigh graduating 94% of its student athletes, 7th best in the country. Joseph bounces off, finally is dragged down. Bryant Appling, who frankly struggled a week ago against Towson, admittedly so, is playing a whale of a football game.
Well, they've had to be active. They're making a lot of tackles. I'm talking about the Lehigh linebackers in their own secondary downfield. You know, the thing that's impressing me about Randall Joseph, Rich, he's one of these backs that seems to get stronger. We hear that a lot about good backs, but he's a guy that seems like he has more power and energy here in the second half than he did in the first half. Third down, big play here, third and 10.
Under a minute to go here in the third quarter. Benna. Benna will keep. Benna will not get the first down. Guzovic brought him down at the 27-yard line.
How many times has Dick Biddle had to make these kinds of decisions? He's going to have fourth in about 2 yards. Looks like it's too long for a field goal against the wind. He's sure not going to punt down here. He's going to have to go for it on fourth and two. See, out of the shotgun now, Venna. He has plenty of time. Good coverage in the Lehigh secondary. There's an arm tackle by Brendan Moore, and Venna gets 9 more yards out of that.
Fourth down, 2 yards to go from the Lehigh 27.
They're going to let the quarter click out because Colgate's going to take the win for the fourth quarter.
And so that is where we will pick it up, with Colgate facing a fourth and two, trailing by 11. But 15 very important minutes left to play here in Hamilton, New York. Stay with us.
Lehigh football. I think 99 cents is a great deal.
I think it's pretty big salad for 99 cents.
It's incredible. It's huge for only 99 cents.
You think?
It's a good deal in any language.
I think I see 2 sticks of bacon.
You think right.
I think in a hot day you should have a frosting.
For 10 years, people have depended on Wendy's 99 cent super value menu.
I think it's too nice a day to go back to work.
Try not to think as much as possible.
I got nuggets.
This one's really good. They're all really good.
Thanks.
I love French fries, even though the French really didn't give it to us.
I think I have an urge to bite this hamburger.
I think I'm hungry.
Everyone's heading to the big game to support the team. There's only one problem. Everyone is sporting their Lehigh gear, and you're the odd person out. What are you going to do? No problem. The Lehigh University Bookstore is the answer to all your apparel needs. Whether you're a parent, child, student, or alumnus, you can show your school spirit by wearing a Lehigh sweatshirt, t-shirt, jacket, or even furnishings for your house. The Lehigh University Bookstore is located on the lower level of McGinnis Hall at the corner of Morton and Vine Streets. We're open Saturday, so you can stop in on your way to Goodman Campus.
Dig it. The generation that said, never trust anyone over 30, is now in their 40s and 50s going on 60. And chances are, over 50% will need some kind of long-term care. But why worry? Just get hip to long-term care insurance from your State Farm agent. It'll help protect you and your retirement savings from the cost of extended health care. It'll give you financial freedom, man, and help keep your 60s swinging.
Ian Easton and the Lehigh defense staring at a fourth down and two for Colgate as we begin the critical fourth quarter of the biggest game of this season so far. Benna under pressure, gets rid of it, and it's caught! Ojeda has it, amazing play. When it looked as though all hope was lost for Ryan Benna, somehow he stayed on his feet and found Ojeda for a first down.
Well, Benna's working his magic here. Look at him taking hits, going down. He still manages to find his receiver. Look at Ian Easton has this thing figured out. He knows they're going play action. He's going to put heat on the quarterback. He's got him. He thinks he's got a sack. Benna gets the ball away for a big, big first down.
From the 10, Randall Joseph.
Fumble!
And he fumbled again. Red Raiders, wow. Nervous moments anytime Randall Joseph touches the ball for head coach Dick Biddle. The reason why Joseph did not play in the first three games of the year.
See, if we look at he's got his shoulders square to the line of scrimmage. He had his two arms on the football as he approached the line of scrimmage, and then he lost his concentration and gave up the football. Colgate very, very lucky there.
Second down, 10, 14 minutes to go in the game.
Counter.
LeBoy. Brought down by Brendan Moore. And right now, the safer bet for Colgate is the fullback, LeBoy.
In the red zone, Colgate runs the sprint and the counter. And that time we saw the counter again. We saw him do it effectively in the third quarter as well. Look at this. Tough in the fourth quarter.
Lehigh also prides itself on being the best conditioned team in the league. They feel as though they own the fourth quarter, though so many of their games have been blowouts.
Bennett. Smack.
Guzovich. Eason. And Moore.
In the red zone, they run the sprint or the counter. Here's the sprint. Ian Eason doing a great job taking on the fullback, Lavoli, and then getting in there and making the tackle.
It's big time play by Ian Eason. Take on that
another
fullback.
Fourth down, Rich. Yet another fourth down for Dick Biddle.
Fourth down and five. Bennett throws, and it's a touchdown for Colgate. Jason Mattis. And so Colgate continues to defy logic in some cases. Right in this football game, despite four turnovers, all of the fourth downs which they have faced. And now it is 24-19, and no doubt they will go for two here. Try to cut it to a field goal deficit. Dick Biddle's team with no quit in it. Benna and the Raiders going for two.
They
try to cut the lead to three.
They like the sprint. They like the counter. They're going to go out of the shotgun. Remember, quarterback draw is still a possibility down here. There it is.
Dim called it, and it's a two-point conversion for Colgate. Ryan Benna makes it 24-21. Colgate refuses to go away, and we'll be back with a great football game. Lehigh clinging to a three-point lead.
You can find all the best books at the Lehigh University Bookstore. Aside from all your textbook needs, the Lehigh University Bookstore features titles from the New York Times bestseller list. We'll also order any title we don't have in stock. Like all great bookstores, we've sponsored book signings with many distinguished authors. The Lehigh University Bookstore is located on the lower level of McGinnis Hall at the corner of Morton and Vine Streets. The Lehigh University Bookstore, your number one source for information.
It's the Domino's Mega Deal. Any pizza, any size, any number of toppings. Only $8.99. That's right, only $8.99. No matter how you like it, any pizza, only $8.99. Go ahead, pick your favorite toppings. Only $8.99. It's the Domino's Mega Deal. Any pizza, any size, any number of toppings. Only $8.99. Hot and fresh and on its way to you.
Domino's!
Hot! Wow! Now!
Colgate on fourth down with this touchdown.
Ryan Bennett, three-step drop, looking to his left. He's going to the quick post, and he just threads the needle. That's Mattis, 88, on the touchdown. Now, if you're the middle linebacker right here, your job is to read pass or run. If it's run, you're going to plug the gap. If it's pass, you've got to fight to get back out here in the zone. Let's take a look at Brian. Brian Appling, he just reads pass. He's fighting to get out to that zone. He knows he's got to get to the quick post. Doesn't quite get there. On the two-point conversion now, Venna, no question, quarterback draw. He had a lot of blocking on the left side. He's just nifty enough, big enough heart to get himself in the end zone.
Well, speaking with Coach Biddle prior to this game, he said, I can't give you much in the way of raw physical skills when talking about Ryan Benna. All I can tell you is that he's a fierce competitor and he's a winner.
Well, he got that right. He is a fierce competitor.
Certainly will go down as one of the all-time great quarterbacks in Patriot League history. The numbers tell you that.
Well, he also knows his work's not over yet today. He's over there on the sidelines, still keeping his guys fired up.
Jamal Bercher for Lehigh. Good special teams coverage, Colgate. They are really fired up.
If I am Kevin Higgins, I am thinking Ronald Jean. I am thinking we have got to get this ground game untracked. We've got to use the quick, short, possessive passes, but we got to get Ronald Jean in this football game.
Ronald Jean has just 38 yards on 13 carries. Keep in mind, he is averaging 130 yards per game on the ground.
And he's not even in the football game right now.
Going with Jamal, or rather Phil Pleasant, number 33. There is the short pass, and Colgate, like a pack of angry dogs, flying to the football.
That's a good positive play on first down, but you got to wonder, why isn't Ronald Jean in the football game? Going down the stretch here, 12 minutes left in this football game. Is he hurt? He's standing on the sidelines next to the coaching staff.
5-yard pickup, second down, 5.
Here comes Colgate.
Nothing doing on the handoff to the fullback, Brett Snyder. Third down coming up. 11 minutes, 37 seconds to go in the football game. Lehigh leading it, 24-21. Colgate crowd rises. Third down and 3. Stanball hits the official. And they are going bananas on the Colgate sideline.
Well, once again, the Lehigh offense's job was to leave the defense in good field position. And it looks like they're not going to do that again. Let's take another look at this. Stanball under a lot of heat. This is, look at, just a 3-step drop. He's trying to go over the middle. Hits the referee, but the key was there, the Colgate heat.
And again, the question begs, where was Ronald Jean on that series? Heibel, another low, boring kick. Taken by Amir Riley. Flag is down. Colgate, depending on the flag, will have good field position. They certainly have the mojo.
They got it. They got it. You don't have it. I don't have it. They got it.
Lehigh really has only put together one solid, complete drive today, and that was to open the third quarter.
Well, that's going to hurt Colgate a little bit, Coach Biddle.
Illegal block in the back, during the return, 10 yards, first down.
Mentioned that Biddle played his college football at Duke in the early 70s. Former Lehigh quarterback Joe Oliva is the highly regarded athletics director at Duke. Ryan Benna. Can he engineer this comeback from a 17-point deficit? Randall Joseph. Good job stopping the run. Ian Eason with a little bit of help.
One thing we haven't seen by Lehigh's defensive front four is a lot of penetration today. We're used to seeing that defensive front four penetrate. You get the feeling they're a bit tired, not getting the penetration. Fumble.
There's a fumble, but Colgate balls on it.
How many times have we seen that ball?
You mentioned fatigue as a possibility. Lehigh's defense was on the field the last two games for better than 100 plays when 75 or thereabouts is a normal number. So it's possible they could be fatigued.
Yeah, it's also characteristic of a big play offense. If you're scoring on big plays, long runs, long passes, your defense isn't getting a big blow on the sidelines. And, you know, Kevin Higgins would rather see the 75-yard drive take 10 minutes.
They need the running game. They don't have it today. Benna under pressure, escapes again. What else is new, but not much doing. And now the defense does its job.
Good job of staying at home that time by the Lehigh defensive ends. And Michael Emery, number 90, he's going to hold contain on Benna.
out of the shotgun. Now he's making his thing happen here. Watch number 90 on your right side. You can't really see him. He doesn't come into the picture. He stayed at home and funneled Bennett down the middle of the football field.
Fourth down, and what Colgate's not going for, high snap, and they get it away. Kutchka gets it down the field, taken by Josh Snyder on one hop. Very nicely done by Josh Snyder.
That's a big play. He just saved his team 20 yards in field position by fielding that punt.
Well, Mark Murphy knows a little bit about football. The Colgate Athletic Director, who played for the Washington Redskins, chatted with us before the game on Venna and Stanball playing their last game together on the same field. Who's better? Here's Mark Murphy.
Both of those players have just accomplished a remarkable amount in their careers. But, you know, I mean, this may be, you know, the defining moment for the two of them. It's their both senior years. You know, whether they can lead their team to a Patriot League championship and into the NCAA tournament will be their legacy.
That is Mark Murphy, athletics director here at Colgate. The pass on first down, Stanball to Ricky Moore, incomplete.
You know, Mark Murphy, when he was an all-pro free safety for the Redskins, looked like Huck Finn, and he still does.
Very youthful. Part of the new breed, along with Lehigh's athletic director, Joe Sterrett. Former players, very cerebral, tough, fair-minded people who will lead college athletics into the next century. Second down, 10. Stanball gunning, and it's high, and it's free, and it's intercepted by Colgate. Tom McCarroll comes up with a football, and there is the first turnover of the day for Lehigh.
Yeah, this is a tough bounce of the football, but the reason the football was bouncing was Phil Stanball was late. He was way late on the delivery of this ball, and that allowed the defense to recover and led to the turnover. Take a look at it. He's going to roll left out of the shotgun. This ball is just late coming here. You can see the defenders already broken on the ball. That time, Max Wynn, the DB, number 9, is the guy that really jarred that loose.
Ryan Bennett with the backs in the eye.
Counter.
LaVoy, big gaping hole, and LaVoy has a first down for the Red Raiders. And now Colgate, should they drive it down, could take the lead.
You know, in this fourth quarter, the Lehigh offense has put so much pressure on the Lehigh defense. Two bad field positions and turnover. Hey, you see, look at number 9. He got a chance to break on that ball, and that's what led to the interception.
First down, 10. Joseph doesn't get much yardage, but at least he hangs on.
Yeah, you see Lehigh defenders trying to strip that football. They're taught to strip the football if you're the second man on the ball. Sometimes you get stripping the football in your mind, and you have a tendency, if you're the first guy, to try to strip it, and that's how tackles are broken. And that's how the running game gets big plays. No huddle offense, Rich. Second and 8.
8 minutes and 15 seconds to go in the contest. Benna to throw, and it is caught. Colgate continues to make the big plays. Barry Hoare, the tight end, first down Colgate, down to the 19-yard line.
You know, these Colgate receivers really go up and get the football. We've seen Mattis make some great catches, including the touchdown. And I'll tell you, number 40, Barry Hoare, he climbs the ladder. You know, Bennett doesn't throw a pretty ball, and a lot of times it's in traffic. These Colgate receivers are going up to get it.
Randall Joseph, room on the left side. He's tripped up, though. Might have had more. Appling tripped him up. But Randall Joseph is down near the 10-yard line. Let's go down to Jeff Fisher.
Guys, you were talking about the defense being on the field a lot. Yes, they've been on the field a lot in the last two games, but another thing coming into play, early in the year with the blowouts, they didn't play more than a couple of quarters, so stamina may come into play down the stretch here. Back upstairs.
Thank you, Jeff. Second down, 2. Ball at the Lehigh 11 with 7:20 to go in the game. Colgate looking for its first lead of the day. Joseph should have the first down. short by about a half a yard.
Now again, they're in four down territory here. They could do anything here, third and one, but you might see that quarterback sneak. Big gap on the right side. There's the counter.
But boy, the ball carrier, and that will be very close.
Yeah, I don't think they got it. I really don't like the play call, because on third and one, quarterback sneak has been effective. Joseph out of the eye has been effective. The counter takes a little bit longer to develop. And sometimes you can shoot a gap on a trap play like that. Let's see what happened here. It's fourth down. It's fourth
they're
in
not,
inches.
They're not comfortable unless it's fourth down.
Good point.
Good 6:20 to go in the game. Another big fourth down for Colgate. They trail it 24-21. Benna has the first down. Brian Benna began the year, along with Phil Stambaugh, as a Walter Payton Award candidate.
Now, this is just good offensive line surge. Nice job by the Red Raider offensive line that time, and they played a good ball game. Kevin Bolas, the center that time, anchoring that surge. First down, Rich, inside the 10. Think sprint or counter.
Bennett, give to Ed Weiss. Nothing doing. Eason and Oropeza in on the tackle.
See, I think Ben is going to want to do it himself. He's now got second down. They just lost a couple of yards. If I'm Ben, I'm thinking I can do this. I can do that. I know I can do this. I want the draw. I want the QB draw. I want the sprint out. Coach, give me an opportunity to keep making it happen.
Second down, 10. It's LaVoy, the fullback, and he is gang tackled.
Hey, Coach, you didn't give me an opportunity.
Leading the charge is Reuben Smith.
Give me the ball, Coach. I can make it happen.
No, he's going to have to. Third down and 9.
You see that it's kind of a fake toss. They try to make it look like the toss, and then they counter. And they obviously run it a lot inside the 20-yard line. That time, Lehigh was waiting for it.
Big third down and goal from the 9.5. Benna making it happen himself. Kim, you were right on the money. And Colgate, for the first time, leads the football game. He is not lacking for confidence.
No, he is not.
Mentioned that he's a Payton Award candidate, given to the outstanding player in 1AA. Kenny Gamble won the award out of Colgate 1987. Kevin Higgins' team in a tough spot. Kutchner with the extra point, and Colgate leads it 28-24, 4:29 to go.
There's no topping for Red Robin. Come on, along.
Red Robin.
Let's all go bobbing to the Red Robin. Come on,
get bobbing to the Red Robin.
You'll find something for everyone. Relax, unwind, we'll have some fun. Come on, let's go. There's no topping for Red Robin. Come on.
Tillman Square in Allentown, and in Northampton Crossing at 33 North and Route 248.
Everyone's heading to the big game to support the team. There's only one problem. Everyone is sporting their Lehigh gear, and you're the odd person out. What are you going to do? No problem. The Lehigh University Bookstore is the answer to all your apparel needs. Whether you're a parent, child, student, or alumnus, you can show your school spirit by wearing a Lehigh sweatshirt, t-shirt, jacket, or even furnishings for your house. The Lehigh University Bookstore is located on the lower level of McGinnis Hall at the corner of Morton and Vine Streets. We're open Saturday, so you can stop in on your way to Goodman Campus.
Next time on Coach.
What do you really want?
Luther has needs.
This isn't a place for my muffins.
And when he needs the team's owner.
Doris!
This is a disaster. No, it's worse than a disaster. It's a relationship.
Hayden feels the loss.
How the hell could you sleep with Doris?
Of his job.
Oh, boy.
On the next Coach.
Tuesday on WFMZ.
We said Ryan Venna wanted to do it. Give me the ball, Coach. He got the ball. This is a sprint. Total improvisation here. We talked about the great flow of the Lehigh defense, the great athletic ability of the linebackers. They all overran this play. They saw the sprint out. They took off left. Venna read that and trotted into the end zone against the flow.
Well, to be a Walter Payton Award candidate says that you not only measure up to a special level of statistical greatness, but it says you measure up with hustle, heart, selflessness, desire, all of the things which Walter Payton stood for. And certainly that award has greater meaning and significance in light of Sweetness's passing a week ago.
Ronald Gene, he hurtles forward and a pretty good run back.
And now Lehigh will be faced with its biggest test of the year, its most pressure-packed drive, although they faced a tough situation last week in coming back in the final 3 minutes to overtake Towson. 4:19 to go in the game. They trail it by four.
Yeah, remember, a field goal's not going to do it. They need six.
Stanball engineered fourth quarter comebacks against Lafayette in 96 and 97, Towson in 97. Columbia in 98. He's done it before.
Screenplay
with time. There's Ronald Gene. They get, oh, he almost has his head ripped off. And Colgate is absolutely jacked to the ceiling. And they are just frenetic on that sideline.
Out of the shotgun, this is the screen to Ronald Gene. Pretty good block, but he doesn't, look at the pursuit. And I'll tell you, Colgate's lucky this isn't a penalty right here.
Alex Houston with a big play.
Ricky Moore with a big reception. First down, Lehigh.
Good throw, Stanball. Bowman on the coverage, but Ricky Moore comes away with it.
Yeah, that's the first time in a couple of series now where we've really seen Stanball step up. Look at him, square his shoulders. He really puts this ball on the money. That's a great throw moving to your left. Also stop the clock, 4 minutes.
Stanball wide open is Josh Snyder. Snyder, first down Lehigh. Ball out across the 50-yard line.
And it seems that, you know, we've seen this time and again, but Stanball almost seems to work better under a two-minute kind of offense.
Desperation.
The flow going, get in a rhythm. Just these last two plays now, we see more of a rhythm out of the offense than we've seen in the whole quarter.
Sense of urgency for Lehigh, the 20-game regular season unbeaten streak on the line.
Stanball can't take a sack.
Gets rid of it. Costantino had him under heavy pressure. Second down with 3:41 to go in the game.
Colgate again wanted the intentional grounding call. The referee indicating the receiver in the area. But, you know, right here, you got to get rid of the ball. You cannot take a sack. And they're very lucky that wasn't called. Second and 10 now.
Costantino and the Colgate defense have really been stout today. Stanball rolling and it is intercepted. It was underthrown for Ricky Moore and Bill Bowman picked it off. It has been a most difficult day for Phil Stanball and the Lehigh offense. Still plenty of time, though. Not plenty, but still time. 3:35 to go.
Really an interesting game because the last two throws by Stanball have really been in rhythm, and this one was just late, didn't have a lot on the ball. wind is a factor down there, but not a typical Stambaugh throw. There was plenty of room for Phil Bowman in that interception.
Hand off LeBoy. No gain. 3:28, 27 to go in the football game.
You think all Colgate needs to do is hold on to the football to break the streak.
The streak began with a win over Lafayette in the final game of the 1997 season. 11 straight in the regular season a year ago. 8 straight this year. 20 in a row.
If you're
best
Lehigh,
in the country.
You need penetration. You need defensive penetration from the line.
Randall Joseph and Michael Emery on the tackle. Third down, long yardage for Colgate. Biggest third down play of the year for the Lehigh defense coming up here.
We see the timeout. It's very important. This is a huge third down play. Will Vena work the magic one more time? Third and 8.
Tries to draw it offsides to no avail. Vena throws. Caught. First down.
Mattis.
Jason Mattis. Good throw by Vena. 2:07 to go. And now Lehigh will have to burn some timeouts on defense.
Well, Vena works the magic, and again, a Red Raider receiver makes a big reception in traffic, sitting down in the zone. They just found the open spot. He threw him open.
Gutsy Colgate football team trying to put it away. Hand off LeBoy, bowls forward for about 3 yards. 1:41 to go. Timeout. Well, we mentioned the streak began with the last game of the 97 season. Some key moments along the way. Lehigh trailed at Harvard 17-0-1 last year. Winning in the rain on a late field goal in New York at Columbia. Toppling Delaware in Delaware earlier this year. And then the come-from-behind win against pass-happy Towson last week. And now it is Lehigh, which will need, it seems, a miracle to extend the streak to 21. Lehigh led it 17-0. But really, if they did have any security, it was maybe a false sense because their offense had never really gotten on track with the exception of the opening drive of the second half.
Yeah, you're absolutely right. And they still haven't gotten on track.
Colgate's run defense proved to be as good as advertised, among the 3 best against the run in the country, giving up only 62 yards a game. LeBoy thunders forward to the 40-yard line, 1:34 to go. Timeout, Lehigh, with a minute 32 to play. The ramifications of a Lehigh loss, if they do not pull this out, certainly their postseason hopes would still be alive. A tough road loss would not damage that. The Patriot League champion gets an automatic bid. But last year, the Patriot League sent 2 teams to the 16-team field, Colgate being the other along with Lehigh. And the Patriot League certainly accorded itself very nicely with Lehigh beating Richmond at Richmond and nearly knocking off the eventual national champion, UMass. What it might cost Lehigh is a home playoff game.
Yeah, that's the real possibility, because undefeated in the top 10, Lehigh was in good position to host that first game, and we shouldn't take a bid for granted, but undefeated, they certainly had a good opportunity to be the home team for the opening round.
and any hopes, certainly this is not nearly as important as the team goals, but any hopes of individual accolades, first team All-America, Peyton Award honors for Stambaugh, probably by the board.
Big play there.
3.
Ben up, and that should do it.
Fittingly, it is Ryan Benna who picks up the first down.
Like he's done all day today, including contributing to his team being down 17-0 in the first half, he comes back and does it himself again here in the fourth quarter.
We have 1:27 to go. We'll come back with the final moments right after this.
We were the first to lead the way. The pioneering spirit is still with us today. Channel after channel, we bring you more, more of what you want to see. Is on Service Electric Cable TV.
Now, what'll it be, sweetheart?
Let me guess. A nice, cold Pepsi. I wouldn't want to hear one of those crazy voices of yours, huh?
Honey, you ain't heard nothing yet. Hit it, fellas.
Ryan Benna. Benna keeps. Benna, the all-time leader in touchdown passes thrown here at Colgate. Better than even the great Steve Calabria, who played from 81 to 84. School's all-time total offense leader. He is, by season's end, likely to overtake Jeff Wiley of Holy Cross and Tom Ciaccio, who also played at Holy Cross, as the all-time Patriot League leader in total offense. So he has not only got the gut, but he has got the numbers. He's only 6 feet tall. And you have to be impressed with the way he bounced back from that very shaky start.
Yeah, absolutely. I just can't get over how tentative he was in that first quarter with an interception, a fumble, some poor decisions, but obviously he never doubted himself.
1:25 to go, and Lehigh needs a turnover at this point. Second down, 1. Lehigh defense certainly played hard today and well for most of the day.
Yeah, I think so as well. We cited, many times where I think the key was the offense leaving the defense in bad field position.
Really, Lehigh's inability to run the football, establish any presence on the ground, and overall inability to move the ball as they had become accustomed to, the reasons they're in the spot they are now. Down 28-24. No timeouts to go. 1:14 left in the game, and Benna taking his sweet old time. Benna's got the first down, and with that, Colgate can say they ended Lehigh's 20-game regular season unbeaten streak, best in the country. If Florida State does as expected and beats Maryland today, Florida State will be the new owners of that record at 20 in a row. The Lehigh will drop to 8-1. 3-1 in the league. Colgate will go to 8-1. 3-1 in the league. That's it. They don't have to click off another one. This stadium has been a haunted house of sorts for Lehigh. And Dick Biddle celebrating maybe the biggest win of his tenure. It is over. The game in the street. Colgate comes from a 17-0 hole behind number 5, Ryan Benna, to defeat Lehigh 28-24. We'll come back with some final thoughts right after this.
Your next flight to Orlando, quick, easy, and convenient. Fly nonstop jet service on U.S. Airways or Delta Express from Lehigh Valley International Airport near Allentown. You love the convenient parking, easy check-in, and quick baggage claim. Nonstop service to Orlando on Delta Express and U.S. Airways. Book now. For information, call 1-800-FLY-LVIA or visit our website at lvia.org. Lehigh Valley International Airport, the hassle-free alternative.
For true comfort, it's the Comfort Suites Hotel in Bethlehem. Located in downtown Bethlehem, just a few blocks away from the beautiful Lehigh University campus, the Bethlehem Comfort Suites offers a variety of rooms and suites to suit your needs. Our friendly staff works hard to make your stay a pleasant one. Try our full-service restaurant, a great place to meet after the game, the Bethlehem Comfort Suites. When you're visiting Lehigh, stay with us. The Comfort Suites Hotel in Bethlehem is a proud sponsor of Lehigh football.
AccuWeather, the world's weather leader, is the authority trusted to help make the decisions that impact our daily lives. With more meteorologists under one roof than any company on Earth, AccuWeather is relied upon for keeping airlines timely and safe, for construction and agricultural planning, for predicting energy needs, and preparing for moments of crisis. When it comes to planning the events in your life, turn to AccuWeather and 69 News. Your life, your world, your news.
Well, a very spirited effort by Colgate, and they are enjoying it at midfield here at Andy Kerr Stadium. They rally from a 17-0 deficit to win 28-24. They end Lehigh's 20-game regular season unbeaten streak, and in all likelihood cement their own postseason playoff bid. Well, it was a disappointing day, Kim, for the Lehigh offense. This is not what we had come to expect.
No, you're exactly right. They got out of rhythm. I never really felt them get in rhythm all day. Never established the ground game at all, which we observed numerous times throughout the second half in particular. Stambaugh, of course, had an off day, and you take your two biggest offensive stars out of the game, basically, and it's pretty tough to win up here. You know, against a 7-1 Red Raider team.
Never really called the name Cody Fedorcha either today, and I think that's a signal that the Lehigh's pass game never did get on track.
Yeah, I think you're right. Just out of sync completely. Credit the Red Raider defense. You mentioned it against the run, one of the toughest, if not the toughest in the nation, and they certainly showed it today.
Well, here is our hot tamale hit of the game. And it is courtesy of one, Tom Oropesa, number 50. Hello there. He greets Amir Riley on that return of kick. Dick Biddle celebrating. His Red Raiders now grab a share of first place in the Patriot League. Ryan Venice certainly solidifies his spot. as one of the greatest players in Colgate football history, if not Patriot League history. Our next telecast in two short weeks. It should be a good one. Lehigh against an improved Lafayette squad, the 135th meeting of college football's most played rivalry. Lafayette at Lehigh, Saturday, November 20th, 12:30 Eastern Time. I'll be along with my partner, Kim McCorkin, and Jeff Fisher as well. John Leone will also be joining us in the booth for that contest. Thanks go out to Bob Cornell, Mark Murphy, and all of the staff here at Colgate University Fine Institution, and to Glenn Hoffman, Chris Blake, Joe Sterrett, and all of the great people we love at Lehigh University. Good football game. Lehigh's unbeaten streak, though, comes to an end. Up next for Lehigh, a road game at Bucknell. For Kim McQuilkin, Jeff Fisher, Mike Wertine in the truck, I'm Rich Lerner saying so long from Hamilton, New York.